Today we are going to learn about automated ligand fitting using Ligand Fit in the Phenix GUI. The inputs to Phenix Ligand Fit are a flexible ligand and a density map showing the ligand. The goal is to identify a conformation and orientation of the ligand that fits the map. Here is how ligand fitting works. First, the biggest region of high density in the map is chosen. Then, the ligand you supply is analyzed to identify rotatable bonds and rigid pieces. A rigid part of the ligand is fit into density, and the remainder of the ligand is traced. You can specify the ligand in any of several ways: a PDB or SIF file with the ligand in it, a smiles string corresponding to the ligand, or a three-letter code identifying the ligand. The quality of your ligand fitting will depend a lot on the map. At very high resolution, you can see every atom. At low resolution, the ligand is just placed into a blob of density. At moderately high resolution, such as 2 angstroms, you see the conformation fairly clearly. We are going to use Phenix tutorial data on the NSFD2 protein, which we know has ATP bound. Here is the difference density map that shows the ATP. And here is the ATP molecule that we would like to fit into this density. Notice that it is not clear just how to change the conformation of the ATP and put it into the density. The advantage of ligand fit is that this can be done for you automatically. Let's go to the Phenix GUI and set up the ligand fitting tutorial data. Click on New Project and then Set Up Tutorial Data. Then select the ligand fitting tutorial under Ligands. Choose a suitable destination and click OK to copy the tutorial data to your directory. Now there will be a new NSFD2 ligand project ready to use. In the main Phenix GUI, select Ligands and then Ligand Fit. This will open a new Ligand Fit window. Let's put in a title. Now let's select our data. Click Add File and you will see the content of the tutorial directory. NSFD2.mtz contains measured data for this protein ATP complex. NSFD2NoLigand.pdb is just the protein. ATP.pdb is just the ligand in an arbitrary configuration. Select all three and click Open, and the three files will be imported into the LigandFit GUI. The GUI has guessed the data type for each file. If you want to change it, select the file and modify data type, and choose the appropriate data type. Notice the space group and unit cell, and make sure that they are what you expect. Choose the ligand map type. Your choices are FO-FC, which is an FOBS-FCALC map phased with the model, FOBS, which is an FOBS map also phased with the model, and precalculated, which will use map coefficients that you input. Set the number of processors to the number you have on your computer. We entered our ATP ligand as a PDB file, but you could specify ATP as the ligand code, and that would work as well. Now let's run by clicking Run and Run Now. Once the GUI runs, a new Ligand Fit tab will appear. The Status tab shows the log file. The Parallel Jobs tab shows the results for each try at fitting. Let's focus on the Summary tab, which shows the files that are produced. Notice that one final solution is listed, with an overall CC or map correlation of 0.84, and 31 of 31 atoms in the ligand placed in the map. A good map correlation is 0.75 or higher. Below 0.5 is often suspect. If not all the atoms in your ligand are placed, it means that there was no density for some parts of the ligand. Let's select this solution and click Open in Coot. We can center on the ligand with Go to Atom, selecting the LigandFit11 PDB file, and Apply. Zooming in, we see that the ligand is placed in the density very nicely. This is the kind of result you might expect to obtain with data that are about 2 angstroms or so in resolution. As we saw in the introduction, at lower resolution the density is more like a blob and is difficult to interpret precisely, while at higher resolution even more detail than this is visible. Usually, the next step after ligand fitting will be to run refinement with the entire molecule and ligand. You can just click on the Run Phenix Refine button, and the refinement run will be set up for you. Keep in mind that it is important to visually inspect the final refined ligand and its fit to density. Good luck with ligand fitting! If you have questions or feedback, you are welcome to contact us at help@phenixonline.org or tutorials@phenixonline.org.